Whoa, what's good, man? My name is Flimlo Raps, and today we're back in the TD2 series. Now, this usually starts out with the narration from TD2 himself, but I had to come in and show this, and this may be a common occurrence for a lot of people. This has never happened for me. This is the highest debut overall I have ever had. You know what I'm saying? As far as I can remember, at least on any of these series, nobody has come to college and been this beastly right out the gate. All right, so I'm spending way too much time on this. I'm literally editing right now, but I just tweeted out. Wait, let me show y'all. I just tweeted out 7 minutes ago. What's the highest overall you ever had in an RTG debut in college? Here are the replies. 92. And look at Vince. Man had an 80. Kyle B. Liz says a 90. Somebody say, yo, I spell lies in these replies. Probably an 88 safety, 82, 88 free safety, 83, 83. Now, I hit Kyle B. Lit up. Yo, let me see where. Hold up. And I'm like, 90? Be honest. Is this legit? Yeah, I was cheesing and turned the sliders up on freshman. Yeah, we had Mark Ryan say he had a 92. Maybe this is legit. Maybe it's not. I don't know. But anyway, that's just a quick Twitter break. Yo, if you're not following me on Twitter and on Instagram, by the way, you should. Because I do random shit like that. Now, real quick, I just want to show it is week one. I did go to practice because if you saw that little clip from the end of the first bit, roll the clip. And I zoom, zoom, oh, nah. Please don't make that call. I went to practice to get that clip. I just wanted a little preview at the end of the video, and that was the best play that we made, so I put that there. Go to skill upgrades. We have not spent anything. I haven't upgraded at all. All right, so bam, go to my skills. 89 overall. I'm damn near a 90 overall freshman. That's crazy, bro. Hit me up in the comment section. What's the highest overall you've ever debuted at? I know the way it works. It kind of depends on how good the best player is at the team that you go to. And if they give you first string, obviously, you got to be ranked over him. Now, the reason I'm here is just to get the, I wanted to get my attributes because I'm going to have to create them outside of here so that I could put Chris and Josh on the team. Also, so I can set the depth chart how I want, and also so I can use the updated roster. So it's a lot of reasons why I'm doing it that way. For those of y'all that don't know, if you use updated rosters going into high school, once you go to college, the game will completely randomize the names, and you'll still have your names, but they'll be like, corners will be like, have the center's name and vice versa. That's how we got Garrett Altman, GA, in the other series, who's really a center in real life, but he ended up being a safety in the series. All right, so we got that. So real quick, what I want to do is just kind of break this down. Let's analyze, you know, the what we got right here. So 89 beastly overall, only an 86 speed, only an 86 excel. Honestly, that seems fair. I can't stunt. We're not super fast. I'm obviously gonna be working on speed. Don't even worry about it. As soon as I can, I will definitely be working on speed and excel. Agility is pretty good at 86. You know, I feel like an 86 agility is a lot better than an 86 speed and acceleration, you know what I'm saying, on a sliding scale. But I still need to be able to change directions. That really controls a ton of picks, especially if you want to bait the computer, you feel me? 86 tackle is amazing. Our man coverage and zone coverage and play recognition is all great. None of it matters as far as I know because I'm controlling him the whole time. So if I understand the function of those ratings, that completely doesn't matter. And that's part of the reason my overall is so high. Some stats that I don't even care about. Anyway, my hit power, though, is good at 86. We hit stick as much as we could in high school. And that's the reason. I wanted a good, strong, solid hit power. 88 catch, beautiful pursuit, another attribute that I don't believe matters when you're controlling the guy. 86 strength, that's beautiful for forcing fumbles. We want to get that up even more. Our press is good, doesn't matter. Our jumping sucks, and I think they just always do this. Like, I don't know what I need to do in high school in order to get a decent goddamn jump rating. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not putting my jump at 48. I'm not. When I recreate him, I'm going to put it at something decent. So I can at least build it. Like a 65. You feel me? Because that's 48. That's like lineman stuff. At least give me a 60, 65 so I could get up to a decent. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's crazy, man. Anyway, block shed 88. That is phenomenal. Phenomenal. All right. Stamina, injury. All right, I came back to depth chart real quick because I wanted to see what my power moves and finesse moves were on. 88 power move, 48 finesse move. So we just have zero finesse moves altogether. I'm not going to take another picture. I'll just write that down. And I will, I guess I'll hold on to that. If you're new here and you hadn't seen the entire series, I definitely recommend checking out the playlist and watch it from episode one. That way you understand everything that's going on. These usually start with a narration from the player himself, but we just got some stuff to take care of today. That's why it's a little bit different in the beginning. We'll be back to the normal stuff in just a second. Let's set this up first. All right, bro, so I finally got everything set up and I've changed the depth chart and I changed some of the players. So if you're a West Virginia fan, you're gonna notice that some of y'all really good safeties are put in other spots on the field because it doesn't make sense for them to be sitting on the bench behind me. You feel me? And these are updated rosters. I don't know if this team is completely finished because not all the teams are finished, but this is as updated as the roster. This is the latest version of the roster at the time I'm starting this. So this is what we got to roll with, okay? So anyway, we got Jeremy right here. We are going to be starting at the gate. My boy Chris, not going to be starting year one. He's really good, but he's not better than this senior right here. Toya's Avery, so Avery's gonna be starting, but he should get the start next year. Now, I actually moved Drayvon Askew Henry, who I did this part of it, I think yesterday, actually. I started this and I didn't finish it, but I'm pretty sure he's y'all's strong safety. He might be a free, but I think he's a strong, I can't remember. But either way, he's a junior, so I didn't want to put him in front of Chris. I didn't want to put him in front of me because I'm going to end up taking his spot. Then he'll be on the bench, which is dumb. So we moved him over to the starting cornerback. I didn't change none of his stuff. He automatically had the highest overall. So bam, he'll still be starting and out here on the field. So that's money. All right, these are the corners, outside linebacker. Now I moved a safety. I also moved Kazir White, who was a safety as well. Again, I don't remember which one, but these guys are good. So I wanted them on the field instead of just getting their spots took and being on the bench and playing special teams. Again, that's why not make the defense as good as we could be, because we know the CPU is going to mess up the depth chart because that's just what they do. So I put these guys over here so that they can be on the field. And there may be some more changes. I really don't remember. But if you spot some, just know that's what's going on, okay? So, also, over here we got a senior starting at right end. And at left end, we got my boy Josh. Josh Bandy, he is going to be starting year one. So, we just waiting on Chris. We waiting on Chris to get good enough to get in the game. But apparently, and I haven't even changed this, Chris, they have him starting. I just reordered the depth chart. And they got Chris starting here, but he don't have the best overall. Like, I hit auto reorder, and they put him number one. You see that? I mean, clearly I could change it, but I'm going to just leave him out there. And I'm going to leave him on that, too, so he can return. It's only a 90 speed, but whatever. Take a quick look at our offense. This will probably be the first and only time we look at offense. But here they are. Greer, Crawford is a beast. Wellman, and these are our receivers. Offensive line. Kind of a full scope of the team, my D-line. I think we saw every other position. So all we're going to do from here, so we're going to come from here. We're going to go to Roads of Glory. We're going to come right here, use an existing player. Okay, I don't care. Go to West Virginia. Flip over to the strong safeties, and boom. Jeremy Davis. Let's go. Back to my place. Oh. My name, show me. That's a disconnect. We don't call that money over here. Okay, my career, yeah. All right, yo, this is a secret message only for the people who have watched this part. I'm gonna basically do a Q&A for only the people that see this. This is a very important video. I know it got a little bit longer, but you know, I needed to get all of that stuff done. So I appreciate y'all for watching the entire video. So one of two ways, you can either do Twitter, or you can do Instagram, all right? If you're doing Twitter, tweet at me using the hashtag TD2. Now you can ask questions about anything, shout out, whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna do a Q&A specifically for the people who see this part. If you're on Instagram, send me a message. Use the hashtag TD2 in the message. I don't really know exactly how Instagram works, but I know I'll still be able to see the hashtag TD2 in the message that you send me. I will accept the message and I will respond to you via video on the channel. I'm gonna do a secret Q&A. Well, everybody will see the Q&A when I'm answering the questions, but y'all are the only ones that's gonna know about it. Appreciate y'all for watching all the way to the end. All right, man, so that was the setup. I just wanted to do that. Hope that answered any questions that people might have. And with that being said, be sure to check out the previous episode of TD2 if you missed it. Also, if you've missed any of the episodes, check out the playlist, and that'll get you caught up. Flimlo Raps, one.